Rogers, editor of U.S. Glass Magazine, and welcome back to our coverage of the 2020 BEC Conference. Attendees in Nashville yesterday weren't only discussing glass. A tornado made its way through the city early Tuesday morning, taking a number of lives and causing severe damage. Here at the JW Marriott, an alarm went off around 1 a.m., bringing everyone in the building to the hotel's safe area. Thankfully, no attendees were harmed. A bit weary-eyed, they began the day ready to learn. Jumbo-sized glass continues to be a huge focus for the architectural glazing industry. And as the glass keeps getting bigger, that means a lot of changes, especially for glazers. Andy Hill with Glass Solutions is a contract glazer in the Chicagoland area who's been adapting his business to meet this increasing demand.
The architects and the owners are really looking for that big glass. So we've put an emphasis at Glass Solutions on focusing on that, trying to find our niche in the market. The most critical thing with that is trying to stay domestic. So we've set up our fabrication facility to be not 100% lean, but more lean. So we're using cradles for our extrusions. All of our extrusions are oversized typically. And then we've partnered with Viracon to build oversized glass racks. Finding individuals to work in the fabrication facility is tough, no different than the field. And so the more lean that you can become, the more efficient that you can become, the better off you are. We can unload a truck in 15 minutes with one guy with a forklift.
Glazers aren't the only ones changing because of oversized glass, among other trends. Fabricators are also stepping up their products to meet architectural design needs.
A lot of what you've seen in today's show has been trends with larger glass, curved glass, warm edge technology. These are all things that now Glassworks has incorporated into their product offering. We want to give our customer the best one-shop experience and finding solutions for their projects. Well, I think it's always important to identify the best you can exactly what is required so that we can provide the best solution. Hopefully we can offer several options to customers, let them select what better fits their needs.
The big glass trend is also affecting suppliers and their products, and that includes components and framing.
We do thermally break for doors, windows, curtain walls, structural skylight fenestration. California Title 24 is a prime example. They've got a very, very low U value, and to be able to get there, you have to use thermally broken products. Insulated glass can only get you just so far. You have to have the frame to get you down even further. Architects want to have large expanses of glass. We have to come up with a better, stronger thermal break. The material is glass fiber reinforced. We can actually put more glass fiber in it to make it stronger, specifically like for this, for the curtain wall systems and stuff, so that they can use the big expanses of glass and be able to have a good thermal property for their system.
That brings us to the end of our 2020 BEC coverage. Next up, we'll see you in San Antonio for Glass Texpo, May 1st through the 2nd. Thanks for watching. I'm Ellen Rogers.